Grand Theater. Alongside me, English fighting legend Johnny Nelson.
Todd, always a pleasure to work with you. Always a pleasure.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. 6'3" tall, the best to ever do it. He'll face this man. He is Smokin' Joe Frazier. He took part in the great... He is the greatest of... Smokin'... Welcome inside this unique environment. These athletes have promised us a war. Let's see if they deliver. Step back for just a moment. He just misses with that jab. Frazier, will we see yet another fight of the century?
Fight of the century. You've got to find a nation. You've got to make it special. Fight the ages.
Looks like we're going to see an early night here. He is rocked. How is he still on his feet? Now they're right back into the play. Nice job landing that left counter punch. Judging this fight as both fighters have had their big moments. Here we go, it's round two. We're coming off that fantastic last round. Let's see if we can keep the momentum going. Desperation.
desperation mode here. Gonna need a knockout.
Use him up top without a doubt. Need to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round, you're getting it.
There's the bell for round three. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
He knows he's being hurt. He's gonna come out and put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. You gotta be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart because he's gonna try and put you on the pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not clear.
Is this the beginning of the end for Muhammad Ali?
Good job trying to back out of trouble.
You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster.
They're going to look at that because it makes the night a little bit shorter. You don't need to get an extra for overtime.
Two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And if you get, you can bang too.
Watch the jabs. Punches that hard, you don't want to trade shots. Big close fight here in this round. Parries away the left uppercut. Talk about punches and bunches. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
It's anticipation. You've got to wait. You've got it. You've just got to show closure to the wind. And just, oh, you're never going to know where the shots are coming from. You've just got to put in a guess.
Say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Tough rush round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on you. That's what he's going to try and do. Lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not until your senses have come back. You out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
It's been a very competitive round between these two. Matt Hook misses. Their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
This is what he's getting the ring feeling like with power because you know you've got a chance if you're going to get something.
They can shake off the cobwebs after a disastrous last round.
I have no idea what they have done. How'd you come back from something like that? Look, I'm priceless. Where's your head at? Where's your energy coming from? I told you, you've got nothing left.
Obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
Power might be the do or die. The power might be the equalizer.
From this fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment. Halfway through the round, and there's not a lot separating these two. Neither man really defending themselves. Showing exceptional chin, by the way. He parries that right jab away. Here in the next one. You've got someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
These fighters are just gifted. Gifted with such hand speed. Movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
This fighter's speed fool you. There's some method to the madness. These are precision shots, and they're coming at lightning speed. What a round so far as we reach the halfway point. You can't connect with that right hook. So important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
What can they change? They can change their attitude, they can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round, because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again and the fight will be over.
Just 10 seconds to go. He is down big time on the scores.
I've been in fights like that.
There's the bell to start round 9. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Those situations, it's just being hurt with the nightmare again. Be smart, be sharp. Don't be afraid, don't get sucked in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's gonna pop you off.
This fight a little bit closer than I think a lot of people thought. Defending themselves. Very close. this round with 10 seconds to go. Here in the next one. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will when they hit.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. Just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
To be so close shows how much these fighters have come on.
Yeah, look at Duff. All the belts, mighty. Send man over the ropes. Man try come for the belt, but I push together the sword. Ended all of your hopes. Now all of your bros are stood on the sideline, head in the hand, yeah. Your joke of the show. Better keep those hands up, swing for the fences. All your going on poorly for sure. How much do you wanna be the champ? How much do you wanna please the fans? How much do you wanna be the king? And how much do you wanna feed your camp? How much do you wanna see people champ? Swing like you ain't got a thing to lose. It's the ESBC, beat them neatly. Titles never ever in dispute. Ding ding, step in the ring and swing left, right, man's head get ping. Cartier ting, know about ping. We bring men right, some somebody shall spling. Ding ding, step in the ring and swing left, right, man's head get ping. Can't try a ting, no but ping we bring when right, somebody shall spling. I came from the Seven Hills, City of Steel, home of the village and brilliant meals. Can't take man for a pudding, take man to Ingles, mommy have a kid on his heels. In the ring is gritty and real, brave art man put a kid on his shield. Act daft man put a kid on his, been bad from when I was swinging on field. Left up, give a brother whiplash. Not gonna work with a sit back.
Yeah.
Man wanna showboat over the top, send him over the ropes like Prince Lap. Send a man through ropes like Hopkins. Go mad like Mike when he lost it. I'm tryna be the best like money. Most guys don't know about boxing. Ding ding, step in the ring and swing left, right, man's head get ping. Can't try a ting, no but ping. We bring when right, somebody shall sling.
Yeah.
Ding ding, step in the ring and swing left, right, man's head get.
Got high hopes for this contest with these two fighters. Should be a really good matchup. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall. With Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all. Thank you.
exchange here from both men.
Those situations, you've just been hurt, you've got to get out there again. Be smart, be sharp, don't reach in, don't get sucked in. Make you fight your fight. Hold it in time and just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, you're gonna fuck off.
Thank you.
complete domination. Let's see if we can shake things up and get this round.
fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power moves.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know you've got the chin that is not going to get bent.
I can't believe we're only halfway through the round. And he misses with the left uppercut.
Thank you.
He blocks the uppercut. Very close round with 10 seconds to go.
Jab. It can be intimidating, just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
As expected, not a ticket left, ladies and gentlemen. We are sold out at the Grand Theater. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
You tried to give me the slip, didn't you, my friend? There was no way I was going to miss this.
And now it's time for our tale. Muhammad Ali. Muhammad. We welcome you to this beautiful. Promised us an offensive show. Let's see if they deliver. Yeah. push output. Thought there might be more action here. They're both going for the KO. It's so obvious. Halfway through the round, and I don't know who's got the advantage. Great stuff. How did he absorb that hook? Catch and shoot. Still swinging with nothing left. With that jab. The counter shot lands. Both men step back for just a moment. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Who has the advantage after that last round? Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
I seriously hope that.
On to the second round. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Punches. Call it the glory division. There's nothing quite like a heavyweight fight. It doesn't take much to win it.
A couple of big units here, so I'm expecting power.
We're gonna have excitement.
Why don't these guys slow down? That's what I'm thinking about.
At the halfway point, and both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs. He threw the hook, didn't land. Quick punch scores. A right hand. Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. A round that seemed like eternity for them finally comes to a close.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
That last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations you've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him. Tie him up. Just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to put you off.
One of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
It's anticipation. You've got to wait. You've just got to throw caution to the wind and just hope. You're never going to know where the shot's coming from. You just got to guess.
Was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
He knows he's been hurt. He's gonna come up, put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. He's gonna be ready for that. Don't fire. Hold him up. Be smart because he's gonna try and put you under pressure. He knows your weapons are gone. He knows he has not cleared. Be sharp.
Chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
What a gift. What a gift it is to have a chin, mate. You know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let those shots go, and it's just bouncing up and they're walking you down. So demoralizing. Absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
But he's not faster. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this. Almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance. You can't leave. On to the fifth we go. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Puncher is. It's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
The one who draws first blood, Tom. That's what you've got to look at. If you hit and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be on it, but you've got to be confident.
Who would have thought Ali would get rattled like this? to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet, not until you're sent to the combat.
Through the round, and there's not a lot separating these two. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
You've got to be courageous when you're getting in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain.
Both men step back for just a moment. Say I can't take it anymore. Round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. What would you tell this guy if he's got to do something different? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here. Old adage is, no matter how much speed you got, timing beats speed.
I've never seen a fight so fast in my life. How'd you deal with this? You gotta hope they were out of speed.
Who thought this would be a mismatch, you are sorely wrong. Let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Sometimes you punch for punch. You want that spaceship to come and lift you up there because you think.
If there's anyone that can get out of trouble, it's Muhammad Ali. He's trying to fight his way back into this. I don't know what his game plan is, or if he's even got one. Looks like he might not be as hurt as we thought. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. A very tough round. Let's see what they do here.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
But thought there might be more action here. your back. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. Both of these fighters have had their moments. Me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got to get your timing right.
You've got to ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable and drag them, get them complaining to the referee, because once somebody with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over.
Someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses, how do you deal with it? Very close down with 10 seconds to go. Well, he is glad to have heard that bell.
Every second, every minute of this fight is important. This round is important. You cannot afford to lose it.
And we enter the ninth. After that last round, something has got to change. In boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take that with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. Just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not gonna happen.
Trouble, but surely he'll find a way out. They're back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why. So far, what can they do to turn this around?
Two knockdowns, and you're coming back from that. That's near on impossible because your head must be all over the place. Your legs are feeling like jelly. What can they tell in the corner? All they can do is wake you up. They can't even go to the game plan. Can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
You don't know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that? Someone with so much speed, you've got to get your time into that.
Even a fast fighter, they will cut you to ribbons, and they know it's a matter of time before either you get desperate or the referee jumps in and saves you. This is a natural gift. Shattered. And this is what you call championship rounds. If you have done the work, slept right, ate right, prepped right, I'm expecting you to get through this. If not, if you've cheated, the ring can be the loneliest place in the world.
Recovery they saw there in the last minute. He just misses with that jab. Halfway through the round, and man, these two are going at it. Coming back to life now. Starting to land some punches. They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
Let's get trigger happy. Because all of a sudden you're going to be guessing yourself out trying to get that shot. And that's when they catch you.
These are things that can affect the fight. scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Sided decision there, a unanimous one.
They've done it before, now they're doing it again, and look what's happened, a unanimous decision. What a way, what tactics, what a game plan, what a result.
What they thought this was, what? But I come through smoking.
Yeah.
Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded.
Right.
What with the Lord, not an omen, still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees, you'd think that it's autumn. Yo, I can't stand these rap boys, feel to eliminate all.
That's right.
I'm trying to raise this stack, boy, so tall that it might fall. Top striker, man, I lick off the goal, so anything I set, I achieve and more. Blap. Soon bring the man them on some kind of tour. Yeah. Enough liquor,
welcome to the WBC Arena, and what a night and what a fight we expect this to be. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, former world champion Johnny Nelson.
Todd, it's going to be an amazing night. As per usual, everybody's going to benefit.
And yes, he is the great. And this one has all of those big fight feels you want from a prize fight. Here we go.
This is one of those fights. Their nosebleed seats right at the top, and they'd have paid a lot.
We waited a long time, and now we've got this fight. Step back for just a moment. Box and shoot with the left. Good job. So much for boxing. This is a fight. Pretty close fight here in this round. Both men step back for just a moment. Last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Just when you thought we'd see a lull in the action, here we go again. Threw the hook, didn't land. exchange here from both men. Say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up. Get you to the edge, please, again. And your legs come back. Because if you don't, he's going to cut you off. Shots are coming from. You just gotta put in a guess. To recover now, they've got a blitz. They've got a blitz. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
Time before either you get death
or the referee jumps in and saves you. This is a natural gift.
I can't believe we're only halfway through the round. But he's not faster. He just misses with that jab. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here. On to the fifth we go. Coming off that fantastic last round, the team can keep his momentum going. Match. This is going to be a fight. A little bit back and forth between these two fighters. He just missed with that left jab. His elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots, but that leaves no opportunities for headshots. He fails to score with that left hook. With that jab. Seconds to go. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
This fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Oh, you know what? Sometimes when I go to the ring with fighters like that, and you punch them, you just want to run. You want that spaceship to come and lift you out of there, because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
Way through the round, and man, these two are going one-sided. What are we going to have in this round?
It's not broken. Why change it? An excellent last round. Everything worked. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. Punches coming from every angle. We don't know who the bigger power puncher is. It's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab. It can be intimidating. It depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Good fight so far, but you can a between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be. Have a second thoughts in the ring.
Can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And if you can, you can bang too.
This fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots. Competitive round with 10 seconds left. From this moment forward, he cannot afford to lose another round.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So time and hold him. Lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until you're sent to the combat.
Away that left hook. Momentum going. You can cut someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
So you're getting in there with somebody that's so fast, you're prepared to take a licking because you've got to get some before you get in close.
one-way traffic. How do they turn this around? Off the charts action from both of these fighters. Is becoming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated, now we're gonna find out.
Watch that jab. The jab. This fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know that you've got a chin that is not going to get hurt.
Who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Either man really defending themselves. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
I've seen certain fighters that can defend due to their power alone.
Forget tactics, they know the second they touch you,
it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you? At the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. They can go either way.
No mistake. It was so obvious.
don't know what they're for.